happens to have the Moritz Hotel phone number on it. So, and we have a phone, so we'll ring him. So 4-6-4-3-6-4-3.
Hello, Hotel Moritz?
Reception here, can I help you?
I'd like to talk to Mr. George. He's a barman at your hotel.
I'll connect you with the bar. Just a moment.
Same tune as my boss's office.
Hello, hotel bar?
Hi. I'd like to talk to George, please.
George? You mean Mr. George?
Yeah, probably. He must have been a barman at the Moritz in the 50s.
Well, don't want to disappoint you, but Mr. George stopped working here quite a while ago. What was it about?
I've been told that Mr. George had a recipe for a fantastic cocktail, and only he knew the ingredients. I absolutely must know what was in it. It's a matter of life and death.
I'd love to help you, ma'am, but you see, old George, now he knew a lot of cocktails. One hell of a barman and one hell of a reputation. He did write down his recipes before he left, but if you can tell me which one you were looking for exactly?
I don't know. There are a lot of them, you say?
Yeah, the Paris Peking Shuffle, the Deep Green Secret, Boco Poco, Blue Helena, Red Mambo.
Helena, yeah, that's the one. The Blue Helena.
Right, I'll take a look. Blue Helena, you say? Let's see. One measure of vodka, one measure of blue curacao, one measure of honey, a dash of lime and ice cubes. Shake it all together and Bob's your uncle.
Perfect. Thank you very much, sir. You have been most helpful to me.
Awesome. So we've got the recipe.
Madame Romansky, would it be possible to...
Do you have my cocktail?
No.
No, not yet, but...
No buts, dear. Oh. No ifs. If I don't get my cocktail, I won't go with you to Komkolzgrad. What are you waiting for? Did you hear that, James? This situation is quite unbearable.
I quite agree with you, madam. This young lady clearly is quite incompetent.
Hey.
We really should abandon the whole idea.
No, don't say that. This cocktail is important to me as well.
Go on, my dear. Show us what you're made of.
Okay. Guess I'm not asking you anything else anymore. That's, Oh, I hope that lemon is fresher than that honey. We've got crystallized honey and a lemon. Now you wonder, how do you make the honey go runny again? Well, obviously, there's a perfectly logical solution right here. In the hot tub. I know that this works in real life, but just the fact that you need a hot tub for it. In real life, I just use a pot with hot water in it. Guess it's the only hot water I've got here. There we go. Perfect. We'll need honey for our recipe. So, on our way to fill up the bar with honey, lemon, to make a cocktail so that Madame Romansky can sing again and we can get our hands back, like Oscar's hands back, and continue our journey for Hans. Now, what is this? Mm-hmm. This is the key, it's a musical bar. So here we switch between the two different ones. A lemon goes here. Our honey goes there. And our vodka goes here. So, switch the bar on. What have we got again? Musical score. So, we need vodka. So, I don't know, does it go... So, I think that will be the second one. And then we need blue curacao. That's the third one. In a different key. I hope I'm pressing the correct ones. Some honey. He said lime, but I guess lemon will have to do. And some ice. Does it shake it when I put it? Yeah.
My voice. My God, that is atrocious, horrific. It was too good to be true. George's Blue Helena is powerless, ineffective on the voice of an old woman.
But your voice is perfect. Don't be so down on yourself. You just need to warm up a bit, that's all. After all these years, it's to be expected.
No, no, I am very grateful for all your efforts, but really, I cannot go on stage with such a puny, pathetic voice. My performance would be so poor. I would get such bad reviews.
You've just got to get your confidence back, hasn't she, James?
I must concur, madam. It sounds to me like your voice is fully restored.
James, be quiet. You are a sniveling little creep.
We'll just have to prove to her that she can wreck crystal glasses with her voice again. Try it again.
My voice.
There you go.
My God, what have I done? My voice has returned. Did you hear that, James? My voice has returned.
Your voice is still as magnificent as ever, madam. But please don't forget, you're no spring chicken these days. Time has taken its toll.
And you're not the toy boy you once were either, James. I hope you have fun on your own.
Madam, leaving you is quite out of the question.
Don't be stupid, James. What would you do there? Your place is here. You must prepare my return.
Madam, I won't insist. Adventure is not an integral part of my action functionalities. Maybe you're right, madam. As ever.
Do I understand correctly that you're going to go with me to Komkolzgrad?
You do, my dear. We're going on tour, my dear. Anchors away.
I'll go back to the airship to prepare my departure. You can join me there when you're ready.
James! Take me to my room. I must prepare. Quick! Quick! What are you waiting for? My fans are waiting for me.
Are you sure you're sure about this, madam?
Shut up, James, and put your foot on it.
She's a great old woman. Alrighty. Convinced Madame Romansky to join us. To join us in Komkolzgrad, so that the director will give us Oscar's hands back and we can continue our journey. Hi. See, he fixed the fountain. Off we go. Waiting for Helena herself, of course.
Hello?
Hi, it's me, Olivia.
Hey, sweetie, what's new? How was it at the Goldbergs then?
Like, alcoholic.
Is that all? What's up? Cat got your tongue?
Well, tell me what you're up to. How's the case going? How's that Romansky chick? You don't think it's dragging out too long?
I haven't had the time to get bored, I can tell you that, but... Hey, Olivia, what's the matter? You didn't even answer my question, that's so unlike you.
Did I tell you I bought this really cool blue silk top?
Olivia, what are you hiding? Come on out with it. You've got me worried.
Oh, Kate, I'm sorry. I've done something horrible. I can't sleep anymore. I can't eat. I keep wanting to hurl.
Olivia, tell me what's going on.
Dan!
What about Dan? Has something happened to him?
You're gonna hate me for the rest of your life, and you'd be right in your situation.
What?
After the Goldbergs, Dan took me home. We were a bit, you know, we shouldn't have drunk so much. He came up to mine to have a nightcap, and then... Okay, you're gonna hate me. Please hate me.
I got it.
It's all my fault. I could never tell you that I've had the hots for Dan for ages, because you're my friend and you were engaged and all, but then we got so close lately and I just lost sight of what's right and what's wrong. Kate, the guilt is killing me. I want to die.
Look, don't bust a gut over it. You and Dan, it's like not real right now. I gotta go, Olivia. I need to process this new bit of data.
Are you like some automaton or something? Kate, please!
I'm hanging up now. I want to be on my own.
Чорні, очі страсні, очі шкучі і прекрасні.
That was a weird. Yeah, caught in a thing. Apparently he was a creepy stalker all along. Who would have guessed?